हेलो वेलकम अगेन, वी आर सॉल्विंग गेट 2021 मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग पेपर वन। क्वेश्चन नंबर 45 इज कंसीडर ए स्टीम पावर प्लांट ऑपरेटिंग ऑन एन आइडियल री हीट रैंकन साइकिल। द वर्क इनपुट टू द पंप इज 20 किलो जूल पर किलोग्राम। वर्क आउटपुट फ्रॉम द हाई प्रेशर टर्बाइन इज 750 किलो जूल पर किलोग्राम। वर्क आउटपुट फ्रॉम द लो प्रेशर टर्बाइन इज 1500 किलो जूल पर किलोग्राम। थर्मल एफिशिएंसी ऑफ द साइकिल इज 50%। एंथैल्पी ऑफ द सैचुरेटेड लिक्विड एंड सैचुरेटेड वेपर एट द कंडेंसर प्रेशर आर 200 किलो जूल पर किलोग्राम एंड 2600 किलो जूल पर किलोग्राम रेस्पेक्टिवली। द क्वालिटी ऑफ स्टीम एट द एग्जिट ऑफ द लो प्रेशर टर्बाइन इज डैश अराउंड अप टू नियरेस्ट स्टीम। ओके, सो द वर्क डन इन टर्बाइन्स आर एंड work done by the pump, work done to the pump is also given, the pump is given. So work done by turbine is H4 minus H5 and plus H6 minus H6, H7, okay. And the pump work is your H2 minus H1, okay. The pump work is your H2 minus H1, so net work done is turbine work minus pump work, so this is given as 1500, 750 and 50, so net work is 2,230. Okay, and the thermal efficiency is also given. Thermal efficiency is 50%. Okay, and thermal efficiency is 50%. So, okay. So it means thermal efficiency is 50%. It means the work done is the work done is equal to heat rejected. Okay, because 50% of heat is utilized and 50%. Heat is converted, rejected to the condenser. So heat rejected to the condenser is also your 2,230. Okay, so this H7 minus H1 is your 2,230. Okay, so H7 minus H1 is 2,230. So H7 is, so this enthalpy of H1 is given, that is 200. Okay. Saturated liquid enthalpy is 200 and this enthalpy H7 dash is also given, that is 2600. So we can calculate the quality of the steam. So H7 is H1 plus H7 minus H7 dash minus H1 into X. Okay, suppose X is the quality of the steam. Okay, so this is your H7 is 2,430 that we have calculated. Okay, from this, okay, 2,430. And H1 is 200 and this is H7 dash is 2600. So by putting the value we can get XXS 0.929 over as 93%. Okay. Next, question number 46. In the vicinity of a triple point, the equation of the liquid vapor boundary in the PT phase diagram for ammonia is LNP is equal to 24.38 minus 3063 by P, where P is the pressure in Pascal and T is the temperature in Kelvin. Similarly, the solid vapor phase, solid vapor boundary is given by LNP 27.92 minus 3754 divided by T. The temperature at the triple point is, okay. So in at table point all the liquid phase, liquid solid and vapor phase coexist. Okay, so we can equate these two equations. Okay, for that is the equation of your liquid vapor and of solid vapor. So equating these two, so we can get equating these two, we can get 691 by T is following this. Is equal to 3.54, so T is 195.919 Kelvin. Okay, by equating these two terms, we can get T is 195.19. Okay, next, a cylindrical jet of water density 1000 kilogram per meter cube impinges at the center of a flat circular plate and spreads readily outwards, as shown in the figure. The plate is resting on a linear spring with the spring constant K is equal to 1 km per meter The incoming jet diameter is 1 centimeter. Okay, so this is your spring. This is jet. Okay, and the jet diameter is 1 centimeter. If the spring shows a steady deflection of 1 centimeter upon impingement of jet, then the velocity of incoming jet is dash meter per second, round off to 1 decimeter. Okay. Now force exerted by the jet is the spring force. Okay, only the force that is acting. Okay, so force as the jet comes to rest when it strikes the plate, if it's force exerted by the jet will be given by change in momentum of the jet. Okay, that is mass flow rate into change in velocity. So mass flow rate is rho AV. Rho is 1000 and area is pi by 4 1 square d square. Okay, so and v so it will be rho a v square because angular velocity is 0. Okay, so this is rho, this is area. Okay, this is a v square and the deflection of the spring is given as 1 centimeter. So the spring force is kx. So and spring stiffness is given as 1 kN/m. So it will be 1 × 1000/100. So V square is 127.38. So V is 11.28 m/s. Okay. So V is 11.28 m/s. Next, a single jet Pelton wheel operates at 300 rpm. The mean diameter of the wheel is 2 m. The operating head and dimension of the jet are such that the water comes out of the jet with a velocity of 40 m/s and flow rate of 5 m³/s. The jet is deflected by the bucket at an angle of 165 degrees. In electing all the losses, the power delivered by the Pelton wheel is dash megawatt, round off to 2 decimeters. Okay, as initial velocity is your 40 m/s. Okay, and in case of Pelton wheel, the inlet velocity of the wheel and outlet velocity of the wheel is the same, so this is equal to pi d by 60. And diameter of the Pelton wheel is 2 m, and n is 300 rpm. Okay, so u is equal to u1 plus u1 is equal to u2 is equal to 31.4. Okay, now in case of Pelton wheel, the jet strikes the Pelton wheel horizontally. So this is your v1 and this is your u, this is your vr1. Okay, so vr1 is your 40 minus 31.4, that is 8.6 m². So vr1 is your relative velocity. Okay, so and at this is your inlet velocity diagram. So as there is no friction, so vr1 is equal to vr2. Okay, so vr relative velocity at inlet will be equal to relative velocity at outlet. So this is your outlet velocity diagram, and the jet is going this way, and it gets deflected by 165 degrees. So this is your vr2, this is your v2, this is your vw2, this is your vf1 or vf2. Okay, so now this vr2, this is your 165, and this will be at 15 degree. So VR2 cos 15 will be VW2 plus U. Okay, and U is this quantity. Okay, so VW2, so VW2 is your minus 23.09. Okay, this is your minus 23.09 m/s. Okay, because this is minus because it is in opposite direction. Okay, so now we have taken it in this direction. So as it is minus, so actual diagram will be like this. VR2, V2 will be this, and VW2 will be this direction. Okay, so the power drop is given by rho AV VW1 plus VW2 to U. So VW1 is there, VW2 is there, U is there. So we can find the power drop of 2.654 megawatt. Okay, so this is the general, this is the corrected. Okay,